Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of the Disney Dining Show. I'm your host, Pete Werner, joined at the table this week by my good friends, Mr. Charles Boda.
Hello.
Ms. Jackie Gailey.
Hi, everybody.
And Mr. Steve Porter.
Hello.
Are you on camera back there?
No,
you're not. Okay, good. And also, if you hear some errant noise tapping around, that's Abby, my golden retriever, who is right here insisting that she get attention and love, which is perfectly okay with me. People are going to be like, oh, why don't you put her on camera? Because she weighs a ton, and I'm not picking her up.
Don't body shame Abby.
I'm not body shaming her. She's just a big, she's a full-figured gal. We asked Jackie Gailey to come and join us for a few episodes of our show because we've been getting a lot of feedback, understandably, that we need to be focusing more on families with kids. And since the three of us are not in that category, we don't have children, we don't always see things that a parent's going to be looking for. So we thought we'd bring Jackie in because her knowledge of all things Disney and, of course, being a mom of two kids, planning trips for years and years with your kids, thought she'd bring a fresh perspective. And just in the run-up to this and talking about some of the ideas of some of the things we want to, you know, some of the topics we want to record, you know, she's saying things, and I'm like, I never in a million years would have thought about that. So this week, we're going to talk about kids and character dining. Character dining, obviously, one of the big considerations when planning your vacation. But who are your kids, and what are they interested in, and which character dining locations are the right ones? So let's talk about that. Jackie, you definitely have a lot of opinions on kids and character dining. And you were talking before we started recording about, you know, like even just with, you know, you have a boy and a girl.
Yes.
Now they're older now.
Well, Zach will be 21 in September. Molly's 16.
Okay.
So they're older. But they still like the character meals, but for a completely different reason now.
Right. But still, you know, having gone through the planning process with your kids, you were talking about, you know, what appealed to your son versus what appealed to your daughter, and how to kind of thread that needle, and that was very interesting to me. So why don't you talk a little bit about that?
Sure, absolutely. So you run into sort of a tricky thing when you have a boy and a girl and you want to do character dining at Disney, because there are lots of princess meals. A lot of parents, when they're planning trips to Disney, they think that these character meals are for girls. You know, they right away think that there's nothing really for the boys. But that's a really big misnomer, because really fun things for both. And we had the challenge of our daughter wasn't really ever into the princesses once she hit about six. But before that, she thought the princesses were pretty cool. And so we would try to figure out, well, which ones are we going to do? Because our son didn't want anything to do with princess meals, and she did. So what we would talk about, we would sit down and we'd do this planning, because that's like the most fun part, is your planning. So we'd sit down and we'd say, well, does Dad want to take Zach to go do, you know, maybe Chef Mickey's or Tusker House or Hollywood and Vine, where they had Disney Junior characters.
Boy, you really didn't like your kids with letting them go to Hollywood and Vine.
We didn't know. I know. We were just newbies, so we didn't know all the scoop about that one. But, you know, we would have still done it anyway, because the thing is that we watched a lot of Disney Junior in our house when the kids were little. And back when it was called something different, and now I can't remember because I'm old. But we, you know, but then I was like, well, I don't want to take Molly, just me and her, to Cinderella Castle. I want to go all four of us. I couldn't believe that there was a restaurant in Cinderella Castle when we first made our trip to Walt Disney World. And when I found out that there was, I didn't want to experience that with her, knowing how excited she would be just with her and I, without my husband being there, because dads are important too, and they need to see that. So you have to sort of judge your family dynamic and see what you want to do. So, you know, another thing is that a lot of people think that they have to go to Chef Mickey's if they want to meet Mickey Mouse. And people don't realize that Mickey is at other character meals too. So you can have breakfast at Ohana and meet Mickey, and he's in a different outfit. And you can go to Tusker House and meet Mickey.
Go to Tusker House.
Right? I mean, Tusker House is amazing. And it used to be back in the day that they only had breakfast for characters there. But now you can go all three. And breakfast, lunch, and dinner, they have characters. So meet Chef Mickey there. Meet Mickey Mouse there. Not Chef Mickey, but Mickey Mouse. And, you know, different locations have different costumes. The characters are wearing different things. So they appeal. And what we ended up doing with Zach was when we went to a character meal, he was a prince. And so we really played that up in our family because...
That's smart.
Every princess has a prince. Every one of them. So he was going to be the prince for the day. I mean, how cool is that when you're a little boy? Now, I will say, once they get to be maybe 9, maybe 8 or 9, sometimes 7, they don't buy that so much. But, well, you know.
There's also a thing I saw recently where I think, what's it, the Disney PhotoPass studio does it, mm-hmm. where they have princesses and knights. And as a little boy, princesses wouldn't necessarily appeal to me. But being a knight in a castle really did. So you can always do that dynamic too, a princess yeah. and a knight, you know? Oh, knights yeah. fighting dragons, you've got that entire thing. So to get the little boy really into it if they like that.
Mm-hmm.
I actually have a question for Jackie. We often talk about the quality of the food at these character dining locations and that we like Tusker House because the food is actually good. But actually being a mom... How important was that to you, making those decisions? Was the quality of the food important, or was it just really about the characters, or was it kind of some blend of both?
You know, I'll tell you what. This is really something that you, if, okay, when you're a busy mom and you work, and even if you don't work, even if you're an at-home mom, you are busy because having kids is a full-time job. When you go on vacation, you are just happy that someone else is, number one, cooking, number two, cleaning up, okay? And number three, entertaining your kids. You don't so much care about the food being a 5-star or even a 4-star or 3-star meal.
But I understand that. And I don't fault parents at all for going to Hollywood and Vine because... of the character interaction and the experience they want their kids to have. I do not fault them at all. I fault Disney. Mm-hmm. Parents, at the prices that are being charged for these, should not have to compromise between their kids' experience and theirs.
Right.
It should be for both.
Yep.
And that means the parents should get a great meal, the kids should get a great character experience, and they should walk out feeling like, yeah, that was $60 a person, but you know what? Got our money's worth. The food was great fine. And the kids are happy. There is no reason that cannot be done. None.
I agree.
None. I fault Disney for that.
Yeah. And that's where it becomes hard because back in the day when we were doing this, Hollywood and Vine only had characters at breakfast. So breakfast, it's really hard to mess up breakfast.
Oh, but they do.
See, the time that we went, it was fine. It was whatever. We were so busy with the making sure we got everybody's autographs and just, you know, we didn't care. So you sort of get wrapped up in the moment of it all because watching your kids just have that sheer joy of, you know, meeting Handy Manny wasn't there at the time, but it was, I can't remember. I'd have to look back through old picture books to remember. But they were relevant characters to kids' preschool ages. And you just, like, even at Chef Mickey's, I hear a lot of negativity about Chef Mickey's, but we had dinner there on our first vacation, and our kids were fairly little. And I had salmon and, like, these Parmesan potatoes, mashed potatoes, that were the best mashed potatoes I've ever had. And the salmon was awesome. So I have zero complaints about it. And, you know, it's so much fun. And those memories that you create, food is so secondary when it comes to that because you want that vacation to be so special. And when you're coming on vacation, you want to take home the fun, you're paying for the fun.
Okay, so let's kind of expound on that then. When we're talking about kids and character dining, let's put the food and the quality of the food aside. Mm-hmm. Based on your experience, what are some of the character meals that you think, experience-wise, are going to give the most bang for the buck with kids?
Okay, so this is going to surprise you guys, but the first trip was the first night of our first trip. So we were coming from Seattle, okay, and we were staying at Old Key West. We went over to the Grand Floridian. We had reservations at 1900 Park Fair.
Okay.
Okay, we made these reservations 6 months ago because I was the planner, and I read and figured out that this is what we needed to do. And so the characters that are at dinner there are different from the ones at breakfast. So the dinner characters are Cinderella, Prince Charming, Lady Tremaine, and then Anastasia and Drizella, the two stepsisters. And so we get in, and at that time, this was years ago, at that time it was Lady Tremaine greeting you out in the foyer before you were taken into the restaurant. So we go in there, and they have this strawberry soup on the buffet. Okay. That we all just flipped over. And then the characters start coming. So Prince Charming comes over to our table, and here's Molly, and she's going nuts about Prince Charming. So she dances with him. And then Cinderella comes on over, and her attention is focused on Zach. And Zach is just beaming from ear to ear with this interaction going on because, you know, she was like, oh, you're such a handsome prince, la, la, la. So then one of the stepsisters comes over, and she's giving my dad the attention. He's got a bald spot on his head up here. She plants a kiss right in this bald spot. My kids are hysterical. There's lipstick on his head. And she like looks at my mom, and she's like, You don't mind if I, like, propose to him, because we've got to get this castle away from Cinderella. You know, she thinks she's the boss around here, you know. And then I'm up, and then after she leaves the table, I go up to the buffet. And all of a sudden, I hear this ridiculous screeching of my first name throughout the entire restaurant, bellowing Jackie. And I'm not going to do it because I'll kill everybody. Absolutely screaming at the top of her lungs in this ridiculous voice, screaming my name. And I'm as white as a ghost, and I turn around and look, and it's the other stepsister standing there at our table. And so I go over there, and she's yelling at me, what are you doing at the buffet? You're missing the magic. And she is just mad, and she's ripping me a new one, and my kids are dying, and we're all laughing our heads off. And I'm telling you, I feel like when they do that kind of stuff, I don't even care what the food tastes like. Mm. We talk about that meal like it just happened last week, and that was in 2008. I mean, it was 10 years ago. And about 2 years ago, we were there, and Molly's taking selfies with Lady Tremaine, who's, like, taking selfies. She's holding Molly's phone and taking selfies, like, up her nose. Like, I mean, they're so funny.
So 1900 Park Fair.
1900 Park Fair.
And that, I don't think, ever comes up.
Yeah. It doesn't.
In our discussions, doesn't it?
Nope.
It's such an under-miss. It's such a... What's the word I'm looking
underrated?
For? Underrated place. And it's amazing. You know, everybody thinks, oh, they have to go to Cinderella's Royal Table. I'm going to die if I don't get a reservation at Cinderella's Royal Table. No, you're not. Go to 1900 Park Fair.
Okay, where else? What other ones do you think are good? I mean, I know from my standpoint, you know, anybody ever asks me about a character meal, the only two words that come out of my mouth are Tusker House.
Mm-hmm. I love Tusker House.
It's just phenomenal.
Yeah,
and it's a good one. It's a place where you really don't have to choose between food and experience.
Yeah, that's true. Although, more recently now, Trattoria Al Forno is amazing.
I've been hearing a lot of that's over at the boardwalk.
Yeah, it is.
I've been hearing a lot about that.
Yeah.
Character meal. What is that character meal? That's
it's
Flynn Rider.
Yep, yep, Flynn Rider and Rapunzel.
And Rapunzel.
Mm-hmm. And then Eric, Prince Eric, and Ariel.
Unusual characters.
Really unusual.
I don't know any other places where you can meet Flynn Rider. Is that the only place?
No, that's the only place.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool.
It's so cool. And he has the smolder in person for real. Everybody knows the smolder when you talk about Tangled. Everybody knows what you're talking about when you say that. And he's got it. We, during the 20th anniversary celebration last year, we were down here. And so we...
And Jackie's talking about the 20th anniversary that we did for the Diz. Diz 20 last June.
Yep. So. And we had our auction room and everything right there at the boardwalk. So one morning and this is another thing. We got that reservation the night before. So, I didn't like make that ahead of time.
Yeah, it's you can do that.
I mean, it's you catch really good stuff at the last minute. When people are exhausted, they're at the park all day and they're like, I don't want to be up at 7 o'clock in the morning for a character breakfast at 8:15 on the boardwalk where we have to allow 90 minutes. So they cancel that puppy before midnight. And then you get on there and you find a reservation, and that's what happened. So we went, and I'm going to tell you what, those characters were so cool. They were really fun. And the food there, if you have never eaten breakfast at Trattoria Inferno, you need to go because the food is fantastic. So they make breakfast calzones there that are absolutely to die for. And
is it buffet or is it?
It's not buffet.
So it's table service.
It's table service. And they have so many good options. They bring a basket of pastries that are house made and they're really good.
Like, so you pay a la carte. It's not a pay one price.
Well, no, it's one price.
It's one
but
price.
But you choose, you have free reign basically of, it's mostly everything on their menu. So I don't remember seeing anything that was on their menu that wasn't an option on their character breakfast.
Okay.
And another important thing to know, I know we're talking only about kids, but just in case people that don't have kids are watching, if you don't want to participate in the character part of it, but you still want to eat breakfast, they have a gorgeous room that's set up aside from, it kind of looks outside and it's still indoors, but you can have breakfast there without having the character breakfast. So it's because Jerry and I have done that once before too, because we love their breakfast so much.
Okay.
But the characters, man, and they know their movies. So they know, I mean, the kids would ask them stuff, because once you've got teenagers like mine, they ask stuff about the movie, they ask about.
Well, imagine even little kids are
because
they'll sit and watch those films 20, 30, times 40 times.
Yeah, like you can recite the whole thing by the time they're, and they ask them stuff, and the characters know. And so they will provide as little or as much interaction as you want, really. I've never felt rushed at, so if the kids are all for it, they go right along with it.
And this is why I wanted Jackie to come on and talk about some of this stuff, because this is like everything you're saying is a perspective I don't have.
Yeah.
Which bothers me because I really wanted to get like a Three Men and a Baby scenario. Steve, Pete, and I would just all adopt somebody and that way we could take him or her to the parks.
Yeah. But see, it wouldn't
I am
be
sure
the
there are people out there right now going, you can take my kid.
Yeah, here they are. Yeah.
I have another question for you.
Okay.
So you were saying that your kids loved character dining and they love it now.
Yeah.
Was there a period that, that wasn't a priority for your family just because that wasn't their thing at the moment? And what ages were those? Like, what did it ebb and flow for they love it, not that important again?
Yeah, there is that. Because once they hit, about 12, 13-ish, they're kind of like, that's kind of a baby thing. I don't want to go play with, characters. But then they were, Zach was about 16 and Molly was 12. So Molly was a little bit more into the characters because she saw how much I love them. So she figured, well, if mom loves them, So I tested the waters with a Crystal Palace. I think it was dinner. And because I thought, who doesn't love Winnie the Pooh? I mean.
And not only that, first of all, great character interaction. And the food was surprisingly good.
It was good.
I was there last year and I was surprised how good the food was at dinner.
Oh, it's so good. Yeah. They do a nice job there. I felt like, so you figure for the four of us, those two were not considered Disney kids anymore because ages 3 to 9 is kids price. So they were both, you know, the full adult price. It was a couple $100. So by the time it was all over, and those characters were so much fun for them. So there was a little bit of a lull for Zach, you know, but then when we went to Crystal Palace, not only did they have fun taking selfies with the characters, they also got so much enjoyment from watching little kids. Because when you're a teenager, you get to that age where you're old enough to babysit, right? So you're looking at little kids, kind of, and you see that, and you're like, oh, that's fun. And so Jerry and I would watch them, and we'd see them smiling. So we knew they were enjoying watching these little kids experience this. And so we liked seeing that through their eyes as older kids watching the little ones. And then they learn about how much fun it is to preserve the magic for little kids, mm-hmm. because that is fun. Mm-hmm. I mean, and so trying to teach your teenagers that that's fun is really hard. But when they see it, they say, oh, wow, that is really fun. And then they loved it again.
Right.
So and then that's was cool. Happy. My husband doesn't care about him, but I sure do.
Cool.
So, yeah, really fun.
All right. Well, thank you for that, Jackie. That's mm-hmm. going to do it for this episode of the Disney Dining Show. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you again next week with our next episode. Have a great week, everybody.